down to my level. Come down to my level. Yeah. What's up? Hey, Rashid. What you doing? What is going on? We live. We live streaming. And it's another Saturday live stream. How you doing? What's going on? September beads from Rain City. Yeah. This chord, my friend, is, I want to say, 7 3/4, a little over 7 inches, probably, possibly, could be, maybe, I think. But yeah, I think the shape always throws me off because I always seem to, this little bell shape, it just always makes me drop them, which is strange because I don't really drop sets anymore like I used to. Don't want to brag or anything, but instead of dropping them, I usually get hung up in my fingers. I'll get like hung up now, but I don't really drop them as much. And this is not the exception, because these ones seem to fly. I don't know if it's the shape, or if it's the weight distribution, or if it's because of the way the bead is. I don't really know, dude. But I find that happens with these. So, anyway. What was I going to show you today? Instead of like a workshop, well, it's kind of like a workshop, I guess. But I don't know what number I left off on, so I'm going to have to fill that in later. But I've gone over two-hand transfers, two-hand assist moves in the past. But for you people that haven't seen them and don't know how to get into them or how to do them, I'll break it down. I'm switching sets now. It's my fidget spinners from Rain City. This one doesn't really spin, but this one spins more. And you really can't see the cord on this one, though, sadly. So. Maybe I'll use a different way. These are my mini standards brass on halo chain and change at the end. You can kind of see this a little better, yeah? I'm not gonna lie, this chain is a little tricky. Only because it's got too much thin chain at the end. It's not supposed to, I should ideally cut this down halfway so that this part doesn't interfere, because it kind of interferes. And anyway, okay, so getting into two-hand transfers and techniques. Whatever your dominant hand may be, if you find that you don't use your non-dominant hand as much, two-hand transfers or assists, which is what I just did right there, is a good way to get your non-dominant hand involved in and what should do. Yeah? So it's not that hard. It may look intimidating or whatever, but it's really easy. So you first off want to try rebounds. Yeah? So if you rebound, you can rebound off the top of your non-dominant hand, off the bottom. When it's off the bottom, you kind of want to push it down. It all depends on what you feel like doing. So if you push it down, or if you have it facing down, you can also rebound that way, like that. And it's good to do it on both sides. Yeah, both sides. My trick is, I have long enough cord to do this. But you can do this with short cord. If you have short game, you can still do it. You have to be a little creative, but you can still do it. Yeah, watch out for the knuckle, because it will smash you if you're not careful. So that's why I use a longer cord, and I tend to do this type of a rebound where it goes over, and I know the bead's not going to hit my knuckles, it's going to come over. Now for you short gamers, yeah, I have to show you. I'll show you. Okay, this is like super short compared to what I normally play. I mean, for me it is anyway. It might be normal length for most people. But you can do it. You can do this with a shorter game. It doesn't matter. The size or the length of your cord will not matter in the least. It's just a technique. In this case, instead of it resting all the way around, it rests like right on my palm. So that's a good, don't use this side if you don't want to get hit on the knuckles. But you'll find that sweet little spot. And once you do, then you can practice rebounding safely. See how it's going off my palm? That's pretty safe right there. That's not going to hurt you. So that's a new technique that I don't normally do. I think what I always do is palm down when I do these. I always go like this, palms down. But I'm starting to do them palms up, and so this is the new technique that I wanted to show you. So to do it palms up, you're going to think of Karate Kid. Not wax on, wax off. But more like just like, oh, like, yeah, like that. So you're going to do that when you're rebounding. So that's just to show you what it looks like short cord or short game. Now I'll just do that like normally, my normal length. See how it looks when I do it. Let's see, I'm able to do it on this side. I haven't really practiced on my non-dominant hand, I'm not gonna lie. So this is actually my dominant hand when I'm going like this, right? I'm doing like that. So it looks a little like a karate technique. And if you think of it, my style is a little martial artsy. I'll just say it. It's a little martial artsy, but it's only because of my background with nunchaku. And so that's kind of why I do these two-hand transfers a lot, because it's just more, it transfers over from using that. So anyway, so once you get, I'm trying to figure out how do I, there it is. I had to unlock the brain. The brain was locked. I had to unlock it. Okay, so when I normally will cross, right, and do a face down, a palm down, rebound, I have to remember to have it upward and just go, ha, just do like a, oh. And when you do that, that's what happens. See what's happening there? That is what happens. It looks a little flashy when you do it right. When you're in between, like, I tend to think of two-hand assists or two-hand style, what have you, to come into play when you're doing, you've got a combo going on with your dominant hand, right? You got a combo going on. And you want to break a little bit from that, just to readjust your brain and figure out what else you're gonna do next. It's a good stall. See what I'm saying? It gets me thinking, what should I do next? Oh, I'm gonna do this now. Yeah. So if I go like this, it'll make me think a little bit. Oh, I'll do a middle roll. I'll do a middle finger roll. See what's happening there? I'm giving my brain a chance to think. So definitely try that. Try to do two-hand assist for a little break during your play. And you can find that it makes your tricks, it opens your tricks up to like a whole different aspect of things you wouldn't normally do. I like this palm up thing. I like it, just feels kind of cool. I don't normally do it that way. So this is new for me, which is why I'm showing it to you fun people. Yeah. So whenever I do something new, I get inspired to kind of show it off. Kind of give a technique breakdown. See what it is I'm doing, so maybe you can try it, see if you like it, and if you do, then you do it too. And I'm cool with that. I like that. I'm down with that. So there you go. Palms up. Ooh, karate style. Ooh. Yeah, what do you think about that? Tell me what you think about that. If you watch this later, comment and tell me what you think about that. Tell me if you've tried it and if it works for you. But it's definitely something you have to be aware of, where your bead is going to fall, so you don't hit yourself, because you might hit yourself because you're not used to the motion. But that's what practice is for. That's what slowing down your roll is for, and so you can slowly see where the bead is going. You can time it just right. Know where it's going to land. And palms up, it kind of doesn't matter where it lands, because that's like the safe way to do it. See what I did? See what I just did? What's up, Corey? Cool. Try it, Rishik. Tell me what you think. Back with me and tell me what you, or show me. Do you like a video and show me your progress. If you end up doing any of the stuff that I'm showing you right now and you want to make a clip, feel free to do that. Tag me if you want, because I want to see it. I want to see people using more two-hand play, more two-hand assists. So yeah, that'll brighten up my day. Okay. Switch it up, my oil slicks, from AO2, my oil slicks, they're kind of hard to see because of my background, my all black, my gothic background. One of these days, maybe I should change it, put a different color back there, yeah? Yeah. I don't know about that. Okay, what else to show you, what else to show you? Oh yes, okay, so I've probably showed you this one already before. Now this, what I'm going to, I'll show it to you first and then I'll break it down. This is a pretty cool one, if you haven't already seen it, okay. changed my set. Maybe you can see it better. This is my Herx, my metal Herx from the round square. Maybe you can see it better with these. I don't know. There, did you see what I just did? Isn't that cute? I can't say I have a name for that. I don't remember if I named it before. I don't remember. I have to look back and on my old videos and see like if I named it. I don't remember. But what you're gonna do to get into it, yeah, is you have the dominant hand. That's the one that I'm using to get into most of these. This is my non-dominant hand. Okay, so I'm going to swing upward, swing the bead upward like so, and then catch it. And once I catch it, I turn this way. That's what I'm doing. I'm turning this way, yeah, and this way. And once I get to this position, I release it, and I let the momentum take it. Or like I just push it with this arm that way over there. So did you see that? I'll show you again. Catch it, yeah. Catch it. Turn it this way. Release it. And swing it that way. Once you release it. Swing it that in that direction. Yeah. Do you like that, Corey? Yeah. I did that. That was neat. That was neat. So try that one. Try that out. Tell me if you like that. See how it looks when it's done fast. Ooh, it looks like you're going like this, like kind of crazy. So yeah, it looks good, but you can start it off slowly until you get that momentum going. You catch, turn towards yourself. See how I'm doing? Release it, push it that way, and it's going to rebound and come back around. Yeah, give me likes. You know you like it. Okay, what other two-hand thing can I show you that I haven't already showed you? Or I should just review and just go over real quick. Let me think about it. Let me ponder. Yeah, let's see what I can see. It's not helping me. I showed you this one, I showed you over, palms up, rebound, palms up. See that, Corey? Palms up. I usually do them palm down and I usually cross over, which is cool too. You can try that. Crossing over like that. I think I call that the X stall. I can't remember now. Exorcist or something. You know, I called it something. At one point, I had a name for that. Damn it. If only my memory served me well. Oh, be on the lookout for the new Beggary Beggary that has not dropped yet, that will drop soon. I'm thinking, Simon, I'm thinking it will drop soon. You're gonna like it. I hope you're gonna like it. I know I like all of them. But this one's gonna be really cool. I'll say no more. Okay, well, once you do something on one side, it's generally best to learn it on the other side. Ooh. Yeah. Like with the palm thing. I know how to do it better with my dominant hand. See what I just did? My dominant hand. But I had to teach myself to do it with my non-dominant hand because I hadn't done it yet. It took a while. I had to figure out what I was doing and do the opposite. It's like a mirror. But the cool thing about the brain that I find, other than it sometimes disappoints me. I speak from personal experience, yeah. But when you have a trick you've learned on your dominant hand, it's not so hard to learn it on your non, because you remember what you do, and you almost already know how to do it. You just need to allow yourself to let your non-dominant hand do what your dominant hand already knows how to do. It's a mental thing. You have to get past the mental block. Hey Eli, what you doing? I'm good. I'm alright. How are you? How are you doing? Okay, I think I might have showed you this one in the past. I'm pretty sure I did. This is, I think I called it, I'm not going to worry about names. But okay, so this is passing with a slip in between as I do this number. So it'll be right there. So that is a two-hand transfer. And it keeps on going like a wheel, like a gear, like the bicycle. And then if you get so inclined, you can go opposite direction. Opposite, wait, I'm getting hung up. Opposite way. When I do it slow, it starts freaking me out. Okay. Bear with me, bad teacher. Okay, so this is like more normal for me. So you're doing this, you're doing this, you're doing this, and this, and this. Then switch direction, right? So then you go like so. There, I got it. I knew I could get it. I knew I could do it. I just had to think about it. Think. Oh, thank you, Eli. I love that you watch my streams, by the way. Sometimes I think no one's watching. Who am I fooling? Of course you're watching. Of course you're looking. Okay, now here's another one that I'll show you, which I'm kind of proud about. Which I did this many ages ago. I'll show it to you first. There. See what I just did? No, Zion frame. When I look, then I screw up. Yeah. Let me sit down. Let me think about this. I never think about it. I just do it. Oh, okay. There it is. So I'm catching it palm down is what I'm doing for this one. Once I catch it, I flip it. So this. Flip it. That's a cool one. Work on that. Because that's actually fun. I flip it. Like this. Kind of like a juggling. This is like a juggling technique. Which looks pretty cool. But you get into it by catching face down, palm side, palm down, I guess. First off. Then you rotate it. See what I'm doing? Do it again. Man, it's tricky to keep it in frame and look at it. Okay, this way. There. I'm a firm believer in do whatever you want and have fun doing it. And I don't feel like there's a wrong way to do anything. If you come up with something, no one else has ever done it, and you think you're doing it incorrectly, never doubt yourself. Because everybody's different, and everybody does a trick differently. Of course, there are certain tricks that need to be done a certain way. But I like to think about how cooler it is. Take a trick that you don't know how to do, and you're trying to learn how to do it, then you throw something different into it that you can do, that makes it easier for you and makes it a little more interesting because you're throwing some creativity in there. And that's what I'm all about. That's what I like. That's what I like to see. I'm not so much a fan of the copy machine style where you see someone else and you copy exactly what they do. You're not really expanding your own individuality or your own expression if you do it that way all the time, if you're always singing and copying what other people do constantly. It's cool to make up stuff, and like, I do that with copycats, and that's what gets me disqualified. Mitch, Phil, talking to you, Jory. No, I get disqualified a lot because, for two reasons, because I do a trick differently than is actually done, or I'll do it like, I'll add something to that trick that isn't originally in the trick, and I know copycat, you're supposed to copy exactly and all, but in all due respect, I have a long ass cord, yeah? Sometimes it's not as easy for me to do the things that look a lot easier to do for someone that's using a shorter cord, I guess. And when they do a trick, or I'm looking at it in slow-mo, I'm thinking I'm seeing what I'm seeing. But really, I'm not seeing that because I'm doing something a little bit different. But since it's in slow-mo, it's caught on pretty quickly that I didn't exactly copy it, but in my mind I thought I did. So in my own defense, sometimes I back myself up and I'm like, no, but I'm doing it right. No, that's how it's done. No, man, that's what I saw. No way, I got it. But sometimes I don't get it. But that's kind of why, because that's just my natural style of playing. So if I'm seeing something I've never seen before, I'll try to replicate it as much as I can, or duplicate it as much as I can. I do try that. But sue me if I add a little flip that don't belong, or I go in opposite direction. Kind of looks cooler that way. So I'd like to see a different game start up that's not exactly a copycat. I'd like to see one that starts up that's more, add your own creation to something that you just saw, you know, and then let the next person do the same, and then before you know it, that combo is going to look super crazy, as long as it has, like, the basic thing. Like, you could start it off with, like, a roll, like a simple roll, yeah, and then the next person could do the roll and then do another roll, right? Now the person after that could do this roll and a two slips or three, a rebound, and then we roll the opposite way. You know what I mean? Like, I'd like to see something kind of different. Not to say that I don't like copycats. I like copycats. I think they're cool. You know, but I'm a fan of the creativity and the imagination of the swinger, and I think that, you know, we stifle ourselves if we don't open up different approaches to a trick and add some variety to it. That's my opinion, anyway. Let's see, I'm missing comments. Let me think. Richard! You're here! What are you doing? What's up, Richard? Oh, cool. Rashika's gonna try what I just showed y'all earlier with my two-hand techniques. Doing this kind of stuff, doing this kind of stuff. He's gonna try it. And he's gonna make a clip. And he's gonna tag me. I wanna see that. Oh, Richard, you're so sweet. You rock, man. You rock. You rock. Thank you. That's cool. You made my day. Okay, so I think I've showed you everything I wanted to show you. if I've been working on anything new, I'll try to scan my brain real quick and see if I can remember. I can show you something real quick before I leave. What did I do? I know I was doing some new stuff. It'll come to me. I'll just freestyle real quick. And once I do, I'll probably get into it. Famous last words. Oh, I have a video announcement that's in the works. Coming soon. Yeah? Coming soon. I'm doing a collab with a friend of mine I met up with last weekend. And I have the footage. He does cardistry, and I think I put a clip of him on the group a super long while back. Well, I met up with him again. He lives in my city, and so I met up with him. They were having like a festival going on at the park I told him to meet me at, and I didn't know they were having this big festival. It was like a fundraiser thing for kids. It was for the, I forgot what it was for actually, but there was a big rubber ducky there. So I took my camera, yeah, and we started filming stuff, and I took a bunch of Begley for them to play with too, and other stuff, and we filmed a lot of clips, so I have a lot of editing to do, but look for that because that's going to be pretty cool. And that was my friend Spike. I'm going to try to get him in the group. I don't know if I've already invited him to join the group or something already. I thought I did, but I have to check on that, so. Yeah, so that's going to be cool. I'll let you know when that happens, when I drop that edit. That's going to be really, I know we did some really cool shit, so yeah. Look forward to that. I'm looking forward to that. I gotta put it together. I got work to do. Okay, let's see. Is this the one I was gonna show you? See, but I don't know. Was it this one? Which way was I? That a lot, so I'm trying to think of what it was I was doing that I might want to show you. My brain is not working today. Oh, there it is. Okay, so on a, what do you call this, outside group, I've been messing around with doing a rolling stop and then catching it this way. Okay, so then it goes like this. So I'm doing the rolling stop and I'm catching it this way, but when I do it, I go like this. See what I'm doing? You can do that on any finger, you can do that, but it has to be an outside grip. And you can even switch grips once you master it, once you get into it. So it's like a violent rolling stop that ends with a rebound. Okay, so like that. I've been doing that a lot. And I think I might have showed that before, but it's kind of like I was emphasizing how it's good to use your space around you. Try to implement your space and don't just stay like in a square. Like open up your area of play, and that's where that comes from. So once you open up your area of play, see what happens there. I catch it and then I'm doing like this, and then I come back around just to there like that. So that kind of looks a little dramatic, but it's fun. It's a good workout. Get your arms in shape. That's what I'm trying to do. So yeah, thanks for watching. Thanks for checking me out. And if you see this later, thanks for watching. Keep watching the streams. We do this every Saturday. I missed last Saturday because I did stuff. But I'm here today. So have a good Saturday.